In this very lecture, first lecture, we will discuss about introduction to course. My name is Dr. Lakshman Mahato, and all information you will get here in this coming slide. Course code is already given here. It is MA101 Calculus, and I will teach only CSC Section A. Coming to this lecture, then first I would like to discuss about what is the motivation behind to study this course, Calculus. Then I will talk about course goal, that means what is the goal of this course and what outcome you will have after completing this course, and how we will organize this course, what are the components of this course. Those things we will discuss in this segment. Then I will talk about prerequisite for this course, that one is directly coming from your high school mathematics, that we call it pre-calculus, like function and other kind of things. So those things, so it is very much essential to come up with those pre-calculus idea in order to understand calculus in a better. So coming to first part, that we are talking about motivation. So simply I am putting one plot before you and try to, so derivative and other kind of concept would come here. So here this system in with respect to sun as a center, what we observe, that is the dynamic is very simple. Why? Anyone would like to answer why? You will see that the mathematical equation would be very simplest in form. It would be just a linear system. It would be just a simple linear dynamical system, easy to deal with. But if you go to another one, that one is very complex. So it is all about, you have to learn the representation of whatever things you observe with respect to what you represent. Even in today's era, people are talking a lot about machine learning or learning kind of problem. So there deep learning concept is coming. So deep learning, main concept of deep learning is just inherited in the learning representation. So if you are willing to get a better representation of anything, it simply signifies that the associated dynamics would be very simple. So it is just a first thing is that get the representation better, things would be automatically solved. So it is all about that. So here this problem is all about change of coordinate. So it is not just what you have already studied in what we call it in high school in coordinate geometry. You might have already gone through change of coordinate system. That one was what? It was talking about change of coordinate system in linear space, in plane, in a space, that kind of situation. So those are very simple. But suppose one space where we study motion, that happens to be nonlinear in nature, and another one, definitely if it is nonlinear in nature, then very difficult to depict that. So if you want to come up with a very suitable kind of coordinate system, you need to know gradient, you need to know Hessian. Yes, any question? Okay, I'm going forward. If you are having any question, legitimate question, just try to ask. And one request, that I will come up with a lot of interesting kind of concept in this course, and I try to explain things. And if you are understanding, it's very fine. And if you are not understanding, ask question, ask what portion you are unable to understand. Definitely I would like to answer, but don't play the role of acting as a person who is understanding things. Try to understand things. If you are not able to understand, I will make you understand by explaining further and further. So just ask legitimate question. Okay, going further, other things that what I told, that one important concept is coming, that in learning problem, as I told that, so if someone is, yes. No worry, I will upload this recorded thing in YouTube again, so you can again have a look over that. Okay, because we are having just limited time, so 45 minutes, within that we have to cover many things. So I will put it there in YouTube, and you can put your question there again. Also you can put there, I will share that link there in classroom as well, Google classroom as well, so you can put your question there as well. Okay, Okay, fine, I'm going forward. So as I mentioned that here calculus is helping a lot in order to solve real problem that appears around us. So calculus simply you can see give a synonymous name that computation. So it is most important part of computational mathematics. So one more thing I will talk about, that people are talking a lot about learning problems. So what is actually learning problem? It is nothing more than optimization. So we do perform optimization in order to learn a good model. That is the concept. And everywhere what is happening that you are having data at hand, from the data you come up with one model, and that model what is happening that we compare the estimated value, predicted value with the what we call it given set few values. Okay, through that we come up with one cost function. This we are calling it cost function, and we try to minimize this cost function in order to match this model with this given value yi. Okay, so we try to minimize it. So it is one kind of optimization. So optimization process you might have already gone through in high school, that if you are having function of one variable, simply we call it f of f, a function of one variable f. Okay, so if you try to minimize this function, so what you optimize this function, then what you do? So you try to come up with two important information of that function. What information that we calling it first order derivative, that simply if it is function of several variable we will call it gradient or first order, or simply you can in short you can call it f dash. Okay, and then that one is if you equate the first order derivative equate to zero, then those equations are giving critical points. That means their derivative is vanishing. Okay, and second information is coming from the function that we are calling it Hessian or second derivative. So it is providing a sufficient condition for optimal point. Okay, so if suppose the second derivative is less than zero, then we talk about what? We talk about minima. If second derivative is greater than zero, we talk about maxima. That kind of situation is coming. Those will come a lot in the process of optimization. So simply, if someone is saying that what is learning problem, you can just say that it is a translated optimization problem. Then if you are saying translated optimization problem, what is we are optimizing? Then we are optimizing a very specific kind of function that we are calling it cost function. Okay, cost of coming with this kind of model. So we are optimizing this one. Okay, and here variable will be theta, that parameter we are calling it. Okay, so if this one is one kind of learning problem, there is one more learning problem that we are calling it representation learning. That means we are having a data set, that one is coming from some source. Okay, so what is happening that from this data set, if you try to conclude something, that would be not effective one. So we have to get a better representation of that one. So in order to get a better representation, that we are calling it x cap or x hat. So with respect to that, again we come up with a cost function. So we try to minimize a cost function in order to minimize the reconstruction error. That means from the given thing we try to reconstruct a new thing. So in the process what we do, so we are performing reconstruction of the same thing. So we have, so if we are performing reconstruction, then we have to minimize the reconstruction loss. So that is again a optimization problem. So if you talk about representation learning, again it is an optimization problem. Again you have to perform these two sort of information. You have to just come up with these two sort of information, that first order derivative and second order derivative, and utilizing those two things you have to come up with optimal information. So all about that application of calculus is coming in linear learning problem. Okay, one more thing that if someone is saying that how we are optimizing in general, so just I am talking about in general perspective. Suppose you are having a function which is enough smooth. Smooth is just, it is related with differentiability, function is differentiable or not. So that is meaning of a smoothness. That means you might have already heard a smooth road. What does it mean? That means there is no any jerk kind of thing, or there is no any kink kind of thing that approach. That's why we are saying that there is a smooth road. A smooth means simply differentiable kind of approach. So suppose we are having a differentiable function, and our task is that we have to minimize that function, or we have to optimize that function. Simply, I would like to say that. So if you are willing to optimize, but what you do, you are willing to optimize this function with the help of some machine like computer, okay, using some computer, but computer is not generally doing symbolic kind of work. So they are based on some kind of iterative process. So iteratively computer understand any computational work. So you have to convert this minimization problem into iterative process. So this is the iterative process. It is just coming from Taylor's theorem. You might have already heard Taylor's theorem. So just that what you do, you have to approximate the given function in a current point. You can start with any starting point, and that would be your current point. So suppose x is the current point, and you come up with a first order approximation, or better come up with second order. Yes. Yes, I could not answer. Hello. Yeah. Am I audible? Okay. Actually. It may happens from both side. Network problem may arise from both side. It is not like always it would be from my side. So you have mostly what you do, don't use video that facility, just go for audio only. Okay. So here, as I mentioned that we are just taking benefit of Taylor's theorem. We try to approximate this function fx by a second order Taylor approximation of the function in the neighborhood of what we call it x. Better take it as a fixed point. We want to take a starting point. Always it should be a fixed point, because everyone may have a different starting point. So for that person, that starting point would be a fixed point. So we are calling it x naught. It would be a starting point. So in the neighborhood of x naught, we are taking a point x. So what would be x? X would be x naught plus h. That is the meaning of neighborhood point in the neighborhood of x naught. So in the neighborhood of x naught, what we observe that we try to come up with a quadratic approximation of this function. So how we will write quadratic approximation of this function? There are various quadratic terms we can come up with this function. So it would be f of x naught plus h time derivative of f plus h square by factorial 2 second derivative of f at x naught, and I have taken here already approximation, so there is no need to put error term here. Definitely approximation means there is an error, so that's it. So we are calling it a quadratic approximation of f in the neighborhood of x naught, quadratic approximation. So another quadratic approximation what we can come up with, that here what is happening, that in place of this sometime what is happening, that we are having just information of first order derivative, it is difficult to get second order derivative. So what you do, you can get approximation of this one further. So like this way, you can approximate this one by some quantity 1 by t. So you can approximate, simply we are getting a quadratic function in term of h. Factorial 2 would be 2, so I am directly writing 2 times t is coming with respect to this. So simply you can say that it is one kind of bound of this second order derivative, or one approximated value of 1 by t is one approximated value of second order derivative, because we don't have information about second order derivative. That's where that time we are coming with. Just we are having first order information, then we are coming with this kind of approximation. So what is happening that we are having is just a quadratic function in term of h. So in the neighborhood of x naught, we observe this quadratic approximation of function is just a function of h. So we just try to optimize this function with respect to h, because h is variable here. You can remember that x naught is fixed, because we are taking x naught as a starting point. As we vary h, we will get different x. So different neighboring point. So that's why it is just a quadratic function in terms of h. Just differentiate this one, and from there you will see that if you apply the optimal condition, equate the derivative, or simply we say it gradient of this. So I am calling this function a new name, g of h, because we only observe variation in h, so g of h. So if you find the first order derivative, that means gradient, and equate to 0, and from that equation you will get this kind of representation. This is the representation. It becomes, so minimizing a function, it just becomes an iterative equation. So what is this? Anyone would like to say that what kind of feature you observe? What is this one? Have you seen such kind of example in your high school? Anyone? Have you seen this? Okay, I'm just asking. Never. Have you seen this? Xn plus 1 equal to xn plus something like 2, or even you can take it 2 or something like that. Have you seen such kind of things? What is name of this one? What is name of this? What is the name of this? What is the name of this? It is general. It is a sequence. Yeah, it is a sequence. Have you heard sequence? So that when someone is saying that it is an iterative process, that means we are coming with a sequence that happens to be iterative sequence. So it is sequence, just sequence. And you are very well in what? Talking about convergence of sequence, limit of a sequence, and corresponding series. You know all those? Do you know or not? So that's where this minimization problem has been converted into this analytical problem, this iterative problem. So just you have to talk about this sequence. And if you are having this sequence, you have to talk about convergence of this sequence, whether it is converging or not. If it is converging, where it converges? It will converge to optimal point. It will converge optimal point. That is the scenario. So most important thing is coming that this alpha is actually t. Alpha I have written here. I should write it t. It is coming with respect to t. And that t we are calling it learning rate. It depends upon our choice what kind of learning rate we have to proceed. Definitely there is a bound over this alpha as well. Everything is there. This gradient, you know, that it will be provided by the function, and easily we can get it provide the direction. In each direction we proceed from the current direction, from the current direction, in which direction we have to proceed. So this one is provided, and this we are calling it search direction. Towards we try to look for new point. From the current point we try to look for new point. So xi is talking about current point, and xi plus 1 is talking about new point. So it is iterative process. So just I have taken a plot here. So if suppose you take a function of two variable, then what is happening then? Just switch off your microphone. Actually, some noise is coming. So switch off your mic. Oh, Dighe, just switch off your microphone. Yes. Okay. I told that just we are having function like this way, And what is happening that you can start any point would be current point. This and our ultimate job to go to this optimal point. So you start here. So if you are starting from, suppose this one is your x naught, then in which direction you will proceed? So the best direction is given by negative of the gradient. So you proceed in that direction. So you will go like this way. Then from there, this one is the next point. From there again, you proceed in the negative direction of gradient. Keep on proceeding in the negative direction of gradient. Finally, you will arrive it here. That means you got the optimal point. So optimal point in the domain. Okay, you got. So here, this one is 3D view. It is not always wise to proceed with 3D view. So what we do, we can go for contour representation of the function. So this representation, we are calling it contour representation. That means we are taking a fixed value, several fixed value of the function of two variable. With respect to each fixed value, we are getting a contour. So we will get various contour. So actually gradient, if you take this negative gradient, it is always perpendicular to the gradient and contour, and just keep on proceeding. And how much you will proceed in that direction, that will be controlled by alpha. So alpha amount you will proceed in that direction. After that, you have to change the direction from with respect to that contour, and in that process you will arrive it here. And you can observe that various issue will come in this convergence of iterative process. Like you might have already seen that some sequence are oscillatory in nature, some are convergent in nature, some are divergent in nature. So what is happening that in some situation you will come up with a problem that this iterative process is oscillatory in nature, but there is no issue, we can control that oscillation as well. So all those things we will discuss in this class. So further I will talk about motivation, one more last motivation of this course, that I have to just, it is already around 46 minutes. So as I told that this one is the minimization problem has been converted into in this iterative problem, and all about that we will talk about convergence of this problem. So when it will be convergent, and so there are various issues. One issue is coming like oscillatory issue, divergence. This one is called with respect to alpha. If you are taking alpha large, and there will be definitely this iterative process will diverge. If there is another issue, if we are taking value of alpha, and then it may happen that it won't converge at optimal point. It will skip the optimal point. And there is one more issue is that if you are taking alpha very small, that means very slow movement of the convergence. There would be very slow movement of the convergence. Due to that, it will take large amount of iteration in order to converge at the optimal point. So three types of issue you will observe in convergence of a sequence or iterative process. So we will tackle those convergence issue as well in this course as well. Okay, now one more problem is coming in daily life. You may have already seen various car and motors. There you can observe two kind of reading. One is speed, that is measured by a speedometer. Another one is distance, that is measured by odometer. So that change in a speed or change in distance, that simply we call it velocity or speed. So all those are what demands better understanding of calculus, and those things will come in detail in this course as well. So I have a few more things I will talk about, that if you are walking in a space of size 1 by n, that means from a starting point to next point you are going a step size with a step size 1 by n. That means first step would be 1 unit, second step would be 1 by 2, third would be 1 by 3, and fourth would be 1 by 4. Likewise, you are just walking. Then if someone is saying that where up to what distance you will walk, then definitely you will walk up to infinity. Why? Simple answer is coming from harmonic series. Because you have to sum up all the distance, you have to total. So what is the sum of harmonic series? This is the harmonic series 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3. Tell me, what is the sum of this series? Anyone? No? Is it a convergent series or divergent? This one is a divergent series. Sum would go to infinity. Very big. Infinity is not a number. Generally, it is a notation that it says that it is very big. So definitely you will walk up to infinity. Yes. I'm talking about total distance. Yeah, I'm talking about total distance, that how much you will walk with this step size. How much you will walk with this? In first step you are taking unit distance. In second step you are taking 1/2 distance. In third step you are taking 1/3. That how much distance you will walk if you keep on walking in that fashion. So total distance. Just okay. It is a first homework. It is a first homework. Just go and find this summation of this. Sum of what is the sum of this harmonic series? Was sum of 1/n. N varies from 1 to 1. Just it is a one kind of homework. You need to submit it. N varies from 1 to infinity. Find the sum of this one. What would you say? Okay, then you will see that. Now next thing is putting, we are putting it here one more condition. A step we are taking same, but we are putting a condition that after each step we rotate 180 degree and keep on walking. After each step we rotate 180 degree and keep on walking, then where we will go, we will definitely converge to some certain point. So again, this is what, it is just an example of alternative series. So what is alternative series? That means here series, nth term of the series is coming like this way, minus 1 by n to the power n. Oh, sorry, not like this. It is coming like this way, minus 1 to the power n divided by n, because we are rotating by 180 degree after each step. So that's here n is varying from 1 to n, 1 to infinity. Definitely it would be a finite number, that generally we denote it by that one, the summation is less than infinity. That means this one is a convergent series. So that alternate, this one is alternative series. Definitely it would converge to some point. So that is that. So you got today two homework. No hurry. Just you can take time. Even you can take time up to 1 week and see the benefit. What kind of outcome you will get it. So it is simply not like that. What someone mentioned, that sum would be 2, sum would go to infinity. So just I am skipping directly. I am coming to course goal and organization. Yes, you need to submit it. Okay, submit it. Try to solve that in paper and take a snapshot of that and so on, submit to submit. I will provide a link there. You need to submit. Okay. Now coming to course goal. So here in this course, actually you will provide with basic understanding of how things change and accumulate. Change you can call it, it is related with derivative, and accumulation you can call it is related with integration. Then we'll see the working knowledge of a smoothness, how we can take benefit of a smoothness of a function. And if you are having idea of a smoothness, we can talk about approximation of that function by a nice function. There would, if a function is enough smooth, then we can approximate that function by a very nice function. And nice, what is nice function? Polynomial kind of function happens to be a very nice kind of function, because we are having very good information about polynomial function. So we can generally, if function is enough smooth, we can approximate it by a polynomial. That specific polynomial, it will come here, Taylor's polynomial. Then we can talk about computation of that function. What is computation? That means how we can estimate the value of that function, that means optimal value of that function. So that part is coming in computation approach. So we can talk about optimization of that problem. So those things, those are the goal of this course. And if you try to elaborate further, so here you will develop a technical concept of limit, continuity, derivative. Someone is saying that what is meaning of these three concepts? I always say that all these three are same. All these three are what, dealing with limits. So if you are very good in limit concept, then you can understand all these. So these are simply very basic elementary calculus, what we call it. Then you will have a very basic understanding of accumulation, that we are calling it integrals. Okay, now after understanding of all these, we will try to understand approximation of the function by a nice function. When you approximate a function by a nice function, then definitely you come up with error. So we will talk about error analysis, how we can minimize the error, how we can control the error. So okay, and apart from that, there is a beautiful concept of application of all these derivative concept, is that curve sketching. If function is, it is just function of two variable or one variable, then if you are having a very good sketch of that function, then we can get most of information from the graph of that function. So how you can draw the sketching? So the sketching is directly coming, it is again application of derivative. Then again various problem will come, which is, that means we are having initial, we know about initial point, from there we perturb the system, then after perturbation, where the system will go, such kind of problem we are calling it initial value problem. So those kind of problem will come, and how we can solve with the help of this technique, calculus technique. Okay, then further you will have a very good understanding of real world problem, which involves quantity changing over time, either in 2D, 3D or 4D. So it depends upon there such kind of that changing quantity. How we can understand the problem, how we can model that problem, those things we will solve it. So further, after that we will talk about algorithmically how we can efficiently solve the problem, which involve optimization, which involve approximation, which involves computational kind of problems. So all these kind of problem will, our goal is to understand all these kind of problem and have to tackle all these and have to solve all these. So that's why definitely this course will find a lot of application in higher semester courses and also in further in what we call it professional life as well. So coming to syllabus of this course, so in first there are four modules. In first module we will talk about elementary calculus that deal with sequence and series, limit, continuity and differentiability. Those are actually, you all are aware of those things, but what we will do, we will come up with more computational capacity of those things. So I will try to highlight how computationally you can use those concepts. So it is if a better understanding of mathematics is what, how much you know computational ability of a particular concept. If you don't understand computational ability of a particular concept, mathematical concept, simply it signifies that you don't understand mathematics. So it is all about that. We will talk about lot of computational capacity of every mathematical concept. So that's why I come up with this module that you know from your plus two. Then in module two, we will talk about smoothness. So this one is the actual part that we will start higher calculus, what we used to say. So here we will talk about smoothness that deal with the generalization of what we call it Taylor's theorem. Then we will talk about approximation. Then we will talk about Riemann integration. So Riemann integration is really interesting in the sense that this purely computational approach to find integral of a function. Purely computational approach. Okay, so here in order to understand all these things, we have to come up with Taylor's theorem, local polynomial approximation of a particular smooth function, then we have to perform error analysis, then we have to perform optimization. So all those things will come in module 2. In module 3, we'll discuss about calculus of several variables, and there what we will have, it will have some idea of curves, surfaces, like curve may be planar curve may be surface curve, various kind of curve will come. And then if you are having a curve, then we can talk about local approximation of those curve through hyperplanes. Like hyperplane is nothing, just it is what is happening, that if you are in just through example I will say that if you are in R2, then if you take any line that happens to be a hyperplane. If you are in R3, then you take any plane that happens to be a hyperplane. That means hyperplane is having, hyper word is saying that that happens to be subset of the bigger one having one less dimension. That means if the parent one is in having dimension n, then hyper kind of thing will have dimension n minus 1. So that is the approach. Like in R2, what is the dimension of plane? It is 2. And what is the dimension of a line? It is this one is the line, dimension of line is 1. So that's where this we are calling it hyperplane, and we will get a very interesting kind of representation of hyperplane through dot product of a coefficient vector with two dimensional vector x equal to b, something like that. Through dot product representation, we represented hyperplane. I will explain all these things from that vector algebra point of view. So here simply we would like to say that this hyperplane always happens to be linear concept. It either it is a line or it is a plane or it is a space, those kind of things. So if you are having a curve, how we can approximate that with a line? If you are having a surface, how we can approximate that with the help of a plane? That plane happens to be very specific plane, we are calling it tangent plane. So that will be defined by gradient. Then there would be curvature term. That means if there is a function, how much curvature is there? Is it a flat or non-flat? If it is a flat, curve happens to be flat or surface happens to be flat, then simply we say that curvature is zero. That means it is a plane. And if curvature is very high, then simply we say that there is a valley kind of approach. Valley situation is there. So such kind of a structure, that curvature quantity, it measured by second derivative of the function, or simply we call it Hessian. So those things we will discuss in detail. Then we will talk about change of coordinate. So change of coordinate is playing very important role here. We are not dealing with change of coordinate from one linear space to another linear space. We will deal here, we discuss about as I had given very first motivation, that change of coordinate, it deal with gradient and Hessian, and you will see that very nonlinear thing can be expressed in a very simple kind of thing. Complex thing can be expressed in terms of simple thing. So that's why we will discuss about change of coordinate, and we will get to know further application of the here optimization, how to solve optimization problem. And in the last module, we will discuss about multiple integration and application of this one in vector calculus, such as that we need to find mass, we need to find moment, various moment, and then we need to find volume, we need to find line integral, surface integral, then there are various application of Stoke theorem and divergence theorem, and you will see a lot of application. So module 4 is basically a lot of application you will see in physical world. Okay. Now coming to course assessment, here in course assessment there are 4 exams in total. There would be 2 quizzes and 2 terms exam. Okay, so if you try to elaborate further regarding percentage of marks, so 15% of marks it will come from assignment, class participant, or some kind of project I would like to assign time by time. Okay, then 20% marks it will come from quizzes. There would be 2 quizzes, and syllabus is already mentioned here. Okay, and everything, all information are there in Google Classroom as well. Then 25% mark it will come from midterm, and syllabus is already mentioned here. And 40% mark it will come from end term. Okay, and as per this syllabus. Apart from this, these 4 exams, time by time you will assign with assignment or homework that you have to submit after just 1 week deadline you will get it. Okay, so deadline, every information would be there in the classroom. Now coming to references, I told that lecture note would be sufficient. Most of information there would be there in the lecture note itself. You don't have to look further readings. But if someone is willing to come up with further reading, then textbook, I am taking it, Calculus and Analytical Geometry by Thomas and Finney. There is one more interesting kind of book you can take as a textbook, that we are calling it Thomas Calculus. That also you can go with that, there is no issue. But this book I like a lot, you can go with this book. Okay, Calculus and Analytical Geometry by Thomas and Finney. Apart from that, if someone is willing to come up with further references, as I mentioned that you can go with Thomas Calculus and Calculus by Apostol volume 1, Advanced Calculus by Kaplan, W. Kaplan. So all these are very interesting kind of book, you can go